It gets a different reaction than just a normal match. And that is my favorite part about doing hardcore and deathmatch wrestling. Two stories I'll tell you that are the reasons that I do these kind of things. When I wrestled Danny Havoc at 17, we set up a couple chairs in the ring, and they were like as they were unfolded sitting up, and then I flipped some upside down and stuck those seat to seat so the legs were sticking up. And when I did that, someone in the crowd was like, "No, no, no." So that to me is like, yes, like that's what I want. I want that hardcore, crazy CZW fan to see me do something and be like, why are you doing? Don't, no, stop. Same thing happened at TOD this past week. When I dove through the lights, a guy in the crowd started cracking up laughing, and he said, "You're out of your fucking mind." It's stuff like that. Like if I could make these crazy ass TOD fans who've seen it all and complain about not being enough hot coals, or complaining about the fact that me and Connor Claxton didn't straight up bump on a bed of nails. If I can make someone go, "You're out of your fucking mind," like that's that reaction that I want, and that's what I love, because that's why I try to do death matches differently and come at them with a different, the same way I think Danny Havoc does, you know, just try to be smart about it and do cool stuff that is also super dangerous, you know what I mean? But to get a reaction from people to be like, "Oh man, I've never seen that before," or "Holy shit, you are fucking crazy," and they've seen it all. So I guess in a way that's me trying to get attention. So yeah, but again, I think that's every wrestler. There's something in all of us that makes us want to be in front of a crowd and get a reaction out of someone. So what where that comes from, who knows? We can get real Freudian with it, and it could come from the childhood or the not enough attention from our mother or father or whatever. But I think that's every wrestler.